to the M3 Bear Essentials. My name is Malcolm Travers.
And I think, you know, taking the idea out of the international, how do you move from friendship to, you know, relationship zone without seeming like desperate for dick? You know what I'm saying?
I don't think that you should concern yourself with looking thirsty, because in that sense, all of us have a base level of thirstiness in that sense. Thirsty in the sense of we're all looking for something. If you're someone who's looking for companionship and you find somebody who's looking for companionship, and that's the game, like, you know, and I don't want to seem too haughty because I'm in a relationship, but the idea of, like, I remember, you know, when I was single, you know, those are the games sometimes you have to play of, I don't want to seem thirsty, they don't want to seem thirsty, and so you sort of do this dance of, you know, is it too early to call, is it too late to call, when should I call, what should I do? And I think it's natural to sort of have those insecurities, and that insecurity is an offset of thirstiness. So I say just don't worry about it. Don't worry about it if you're being thirsty or not. Because, you know, we're all thirsty. We're all looking, you know, I don't want to say blanket statement. A lot of people are looking for companionship. And if you're looking for a dude and he's responding to it, he's looking for companionship too. So if he throws back the thirstiness at you, you can clearly just throw it back at him. Because, you know, at the end of the day, he wants dick just as much as you do. And he wants love just as much as you do.
The idea of desperation to me, the reason it scares people is that they're not going to trust your judgment, is what I would say. What you're looking for most in a partner is someone who makes good decisions. So, like, if you are throwing yourself at someone you don't know, this shows bad judgment sometimes, you know what I mean? Even if you have those feelings, you can at least sometimes be reserved. It's kind of like a balance of a certain point. Like, you have those feelings, but what do you do with them? What choices do you make based on those feelings? And so, obviously, different people are going to have different assessments of what you are, and no matter what you do, you're going to be criticized by somebody for whatever you do. So I'm not saying that you should always constantly be thinking about what someone else is thinking. But I would say, think about what you would think of yourself. You know, use your own judgment as an indication. Like, if someone came to me acting the way that I'm acting, how would I react?
You know what I'm saying? That's a good one. That's a
real because everyone one. Has their own standard, and just at least live up to your own standards.
Oh my gosh, I just told somebody that not even 2 hours ago, like about maybe 30 minutes before we got on this call. Is because you can't. I definitely agree with what everybody's saying. Definitely, in particular, what Breeze has said. Well, you can't really worry about if the other person is going to think you thirsty and all this other stuff. If you can't really worry about that, because if you worry about that, you're going to always end up stuck right in the same space where you are now. You're going to keep thinking, okay, I can't go too far, I can't say that too much. Say it what it is. Like Malcolm said, if that's something, how would you feel if someone said that to you? You know, and if you feel you wouldn't be offended by it, then go for it. That's what I think. I'm the type of person, I believe in going balls out. If you like somebody, you like them, let them know it. Especially if y'all been kicking it on for a minute, just let them know it. Just put it all on the line. I don't think you gain nothing by being reserved. I mean, yeah. You put it all out there.
That's like the biggest fear, I think, is you know, you don't want to be embarrassed. You know, particularly if you like somebody and you're putting this out there, it is embarrassing. Like, it is embarrassing if you like somebody and you put forth an effort and you get smacked down. It hurts. It's a big round. It does hurt.
The football is getting yanked.
The thing is, however, it's part of growing up. It's part of growing pains. And keep in mind, it's happened to all of us. It's happened to everybody.
Never happened to me. I didn't know what you were talking about.
I thought Gerald and Rob. I don't want to know more from Gerald. What's up, dude?
What's going on, Gerald?
Yeah, I'm doing like.
But like, just don't be afraid of it. Like, it's going to hurt. It's going to happen. And you know, then you scar, and then you move on. Then you get. It's like working that muscle. It's working that, you know, being able to talk to people muscle, being able to approach someone, and then you'll get more confident in it. But you know, don't be afraid of being rejected, because it might happen, it might not. But don't be afraid of it.
And the right person
will appreciate your guts, and well, the right person will interpret it not being as thirsty, but as being assertive, and that's the dude.
Yeah, you can be more subtle in how you say you're attracted to someone. You know, you don't have to say, you know, I want to get on that dick.
unless the both of y'all want to get on that dick.
Yeah, that's going to turn you off.
Yeah. I think you look, you know, that's a really nice outfit. You know, or you looking good today. You know, something simple.
Well, it's funny how, like, when it comes to issues of people and interactions, you are guaranteed not to like everybody that likes you, and vice versa. Because you see, like, in like a lot of groups that have a lot of single people, there you have a lot of people that are like, I can't find anybody, but I guarantee you that they have turned down plenty of people.
So true.
That's very true.
It's not the ones that they want. I mean, and it's inevitable. For some reason, we human beings tend to want the things that we can't have, or want the things that we already don't have.
They say they can't find anybody. They can't find anybody that they want, I guess.
Right. Yeah. Right. Well, they say, oh, nobody wants. Those people that want you, you just don't want them.
Right.
That's just what it is.
Those
people that want you.
And it definitely goes into, like, what, you know, why do you want somebody? Because a lot of times people really don't really ask that question. And it's one of those things where, which is an offshoot, and I think we might be coming up to that subject, but, you know, when people want to be in a relationship solely for the fact that everybody around them is in a relationship.
Yeah.
You know, they're just, not that they really want to be in a relationship or they even care to be in a relationship, but they, one of their friends is, and so they're just trying to fit in with them. And, you know, a lot of times you really do have to sit back and go, like, you know, I think I'm cool being single. Or I'm cool being single right now. You know, a lot of people sort of like, you know, I need to get married. Because, you know, gay men have that same sort of stereotypical biological clock as women, of like, you know, by 30 I need to get married with children, 30 get married with children. Gay men tend to do that too, of like, you know, I want to get coupled up, oh my God, I want to get coupled up, I want to have a baby, I want to have a kid. And you really, I think it would behoove people to stop and think, what do you in particular want? Like, not what you, you know, stop trying to act like what, we know what you're trying to represent, but what do you really want? Because if you're 30 and single, that's totally cool. If you got like a good set of friends and, you know, you do what you need to do and you're content, you know, and you don't need to be with somebody, that's totally fine. You know, you don't have to be in a relationship just because everybody's in a relationship.
Saying people need to recognize that they need to do what makes them happy, regardless of whether or not it fits into the people around them or not. So
yeah. For me, the word thirsty, just going back to the topic at hand, it just, to me, that word is passed around so nonchalantly that it's like got to the point where I've gotten tired of seeing it in some places. Yeah. Like thirst traps. I don't get them.
Thirst traps? I've never heard of thirst.
You never heard of thirst traps?
What's a thirst trap? I never heard of thirst trap.
It's when somebody pretty much posts a picture and then they'll hashtag it thirst trap.
It's just somebody like posting a provocative picture trying to get likes to it or something like that?
Yeah. Likes, inboxes, like even,
oh,
you know, thirst trap.
Is that a thirst trap?
Yeah, thirst trap or thought trap. Either one. They both for interchange. when you post a picture, like, to me, one of the biggest thought traps is when somebody posts a picture, when they post a picture of themselves and say, would you date me?
And something that sometimes is provocative, but actually it's a really halfway good looking, really good looking dude, mm-hmm. with the quote of, I'm so ugly. And I'm like,
Because in my mind, it's like they're the ones who are being thirsty. They're being thirsty for life. They're being exactly. thirsty for
You know, people want to be with other balanced people. They don't want to be, you know, I will be in a relationship with anyone because I'm desperate kind of guy. You don't, and when that desperation is over, see, the problem is once that need has been fulfilled, they're just going to move on to someone who's more compatible.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? So they want somebody who I think just intuitively is comfortable being single, you know, because then you get to choose them. You don't just pick them because you need somebody. You know what I mean? You want to pick them because that is the somebody you want to be with. And I think intuitively people get that. And that's why they run from those desperate people. So, anyway. So be happy being single.
Yes. And it's not sexy. It's not sexy. You know, it's like, you know, please, baby, baby. I'm like, you just fucked up my whole picture of you. Like,
you're like, it just want to fuck with you. Talk to 90% of the people that find him attractive, if he was to talk to him, he would send them flowers every day to their house, to their job, showing up, saying, baby, just give me. I cannot even fathom the idea that these people turn them down. Just because he's being, really want to be
with them. I think
you're an anomaly. I could totally see
a woman going, like, you're doing too much. You're fucking up the illusion. That's not sexy.
I know.
I'm
not going to disappear once. That's what I'm saying. I think the initial reaction would be, like, I'm going to fuck. Right. And then, you know, 2 weeks, 3 months later, they'd be like, baby, you claim me.
Thank you for watching. Please like, comment, and share our content. And for more information, visit MailMediaMind.com.